Swift students, this is Prof G. This is the final video, part 6 of the Showrunner app accessing the TV Maze API. And if you've been following this series, you know that this was presented as a solution for an actual midterm in my Swift course. Now in this final video, we're going to start with a blank screen showing none of the elements that are on the initial view controller, the search view controller. Then we're going to play the TV startup sound that was added in an earlier video. We're going to fade in the image view that contains the Showrunner logo. We'll do this over 5 seconds. Now at that point, we'll also start a 4-second delay, then animate the remaining elements over 1 second so that the fade animations all stop at the same time. Now to produce these effects, we're going to set the alpha property for our interface elements to 0.0. Now that means that those objects are going to be entirely transparent. Then we're going to use the UIView.animate method to animate these properties to alpha 1.0, which is completely opaque. So let's get at it. We're doing all of the work in this video in the searchViewController.swift file. We've already declared our IB outlets when we set up our user interface in an earlier video. So now let's first set the alpha property of all four of these elements to 0 so that they start off as transparent or hidden. And so in ViewDidLoad, we'll say ImageView.alpha equals 0.0, SearchShowLabel.alpha equals 0.0, SearchTextField.alpha equals 0.0, and SearchButton.alpha equals 0.0. Now let's play the sound that we added to our asset catalog in an earlier video. Now our students know from their earlier work that if they want to play sound, we first got to import AV Foundation. So we'll import AV Foundation, then we'll create an audio player property. We'll say var audio player colon AV audio player exclamation point. And next we're going to write a play sound function that's going to play a sound file in the assets catalog if we pass it in a string, which is the name of that asset. Now our students have done this a bunch of times in class, so I won't describe it in too much detail. If you're new to this, you can go back to the You Are Awesome app and find out more about this in detail. But we usually set this up in a function that we call play sound, so we'll say func play sound, and in between parentheses, this function accepts one parameter, which is the string of the file that we're going to be playing. So we'll say name colon string, and then in between the curlies, we'll first try to get the data that's inside of that sound file as an NSData asset. So we'll say if let sound equals NSData asset, open parens. We want to create this NSData asset by selecting the option with the name property, and we're going to pass in our name variable. And if this doesn't work out after the curlies, we also have an else clause, and in between curlies, we'll just print out an error here saying print error, could not read data from file string interp name. And we'll put in an angry emoji before the error. Now, if the if statement here works out and we do have the NSData asset from the asset catalog, we'll next try to load the data value into our AV audio player and then play it. Now, putting the data into the AV audio player could throw an error, so we need to place that as part of a try statement inside of a do catch clause. So first, we'll add do open and close curlies, followed by catch open and close curlies. Our catch is going to involve printing an error statement, so I'm just going to grab the first error statement that we put in the else clause down here, copy it, paste it into the catch area, and then I'll modify it, getting rid of this part that says could not read data from file. In the string interp, we'll just print out error.localizedDescription, and I'll put in a little bit more text in there, could not initialize AV audio player object. Then in the do clause, we're going to take our audio player variable that we created as a property of this class, and we're going to set that equal to try. We need to use try because when we set up the AV audio player next, watch this, AV audio player, then we're going to open parentheses and we're going to load into the AV audio player our data. So we're going to select this option that says data, but you see how it says throws in there? That's why we've got to use a try in front of this, and that's why we got to put it inside of a do catch clause. Try goes into the do part, it potentially throws an error, and if it does throw the error, that's caught in the catch clause. But press return to accept this. Then we created the sound constant up front from our NSData asset, but we don't just pass in sound, we actually have to get into the sound.data property. Now I know the terminology is a little convoluted because up top with the if let statement we created something called an NSData asset. Then we need to get into the data asset and access its .data property. But once you do this, you're going to have a function that you can reuse. Then on the next line, if we've got our data loaded into our AV audio player, we're ready to play it. So we just say audio player.play open and close parens. That's it. Now to play the sound up in ViewDidLoad, we can just add play sound. We're going to pass in the name value, and just to double check what it's called, we can revisit our assets catalog and we see, oh yeah, it's called TV-startup-sound. So I'm just going to copy that name here, paste it in between the double quotes, and we're ready to play our sound. Now let's perform our final fade in animations, and I'd mention in the question that you want to do this after the view has appeared, so we need to create a ViewDidAppear function. So below ViewDidLoad, I'll enter ViewDidAppear, select this option, Xcode writes the function stub for me. Now we learned in earlier videos that we also need to call super here, so we'll say super.ViewDidAppear, and we'll pass in the animated parameter. And then to perform the fade in animation, we're going to say UIView.animate, open parentheses, and we have lots of different options for our UIView.animate. Now we're going to select this first one here that has a duration, and then we set our animations. So we'll press return here. For our duration, since we wanted to fade this in over 5 seconds, we'll put in 5.0. For animations, I'm going to put in an open and close curly, and then inside of this, I'm going to put in the end state that I want the animation to arrive at when those 5 seconds are up. Now, since I'm going to be fading in, I'm just going to highlight and copy this imageView.alpha.0. I'm going to change the alpha to 1, so it's going to take 5 seconds to go from 0 to 1, and that'll offer a fade-in effect. And since I'm inside of a closure here, inside of curlies, I've got to precede the imageView.alpha with self. If you forget this, Xcode will remind you. Now next up, we want to animate the remaining three user interface objects in after a 4 second delay. So we've got a 5 second animation happening above. We're going to wait 4 seconds and then we're going to fade in the remaining three items in with a 1 second delay. So the animations will both complete at the same time. It's just the last three elements will fade in much faster than the first. This will make the logo fade in more dramatically and more slowly by itself during the first 4 seconds with the sound playing in the background. So in order to set this up, we'll say UIView.animate. Open parentheses, and we want to fade in with a duration of 1.0, but we want a delay of 4.0. So we're going to choose, unfortunately, we don't have an option here that has just the limited amount of parameters that we need. So we're going to select this bottom option, which has all of the different parameters that we could use, and we'll just delete the ones that we don't need. So press return here. And by the way, you could just type in these parameters if you wanted to as well, but it's nice to have code completion fill everything out for us. So our duration is going to be 1.0. Again, the animation is going to take 1 second, but for our delay, if we tab over here, we're going to put in 4.0. seconds. Then I don't need any of the options between delay and animation, so I'm just going to highlight that area and cut this out, make sure that I leave my comma in there. Now I also don't need the completion handler at the end, so I'm going to delete the completion property at the end, and I also don't need the comma in front of that. After animations, I'm going to put my open and close curlies, and I'm just going to select the three objects that I want to animate up here, the show search label, the search text field, and the search button, paste them in between my curlies to animate, change the 0.1s to 1.0 so that they fade in and they're completely opaque, and then I'll copy the self dot, put that in the front, then I'll build and run. Hammer time. Looking good. This is going to be the very end of our app, and let's marvel at the magnificence of our opening of the app. Wonderful! We've got some sound, we've got a dramatic fade-in over 5 seconds of our logo. After the 4 seconds, we have a fade-in of the next three interface items. They take 1 second, so everything is done animating at the same time. I'll click in the text field. Let's do a search to see if we have any shows that start with Swift. Let's check the rating to see the very best Swift show. And oh, it seems that the API might have done some kind of approximation in here, so the Night Shift shows up for Swift. We've also got some shows in here in languages that I'm not familiar with. Whoop, this is in Icelandic. This is a comedy and the description has the word shift in there. But if we go back, we see there are a few in here that mention Swift. Oh, here's one called Swift Justice. That sounds spectacular. Let's click on that guy. And James McCaffrey is the former NYPD detective and Navy SEAL. Sounds quite dramatic. So I hope that you feel that you've got some Swift justice after going through this exam. Hopefully it went well. If you're following along on YouTube, let us know. Give us a thumbs up and a comment. Keep at it, Swifter. Nice work.